It's very important, guys, to do your psyche a favor sometimes and create a space for variety when it comes to watching anime. Really, this idea can be applied to anything you're doing. You never know what you may end up being a fan of. Today's anime is a show from 2001 called Noir. Getting right into it, this is one of those shows for all my men and women over here who are a bit up there in age, rather be physically or mentally, and really appreciate sitting down for a good old anime experience that ditches the overwhelming amounts of childish comedy and use of fan service and action for something that literally feels like a 007 movie turned anime series. This calls for a more cerebral typed mind of viewership, or those who just want something more calm with small peaks of heart racing stealth and action. The dynamic of Noir's plot is not unlike many you've seen before, with two individuals, in this case two women, who identify with the occupancy of assassins knocking down criminals and terrorists. What sets this show apart from the others that you watch with a similar premise is the mystery element behind one of our protagonists, who have no idea who she is and why she's even here. She has a very advanced skill set when it comes to her stealthiness and ability to handle firearms, and it plays a very important role in the incredible action scenes you will encounter while watching this. In the first episode, our amnesiac character, Karika, runs down on our other main character, the lovely Marielle, seeking answers to the history that lies between the two of them. Even though Marielle doesn't know who the hell this girl is, by the end of the episode, Marielle agrees to work with her to figure this all out, while combining forces to create an assassin duo under the alias Noir. This sends viewers down an episodic journey where every episode revolves around a different target, while dropping clues that correlate to the plot's ultimate intentions. At this point, it's going to be completely subjective what quality this story is going to be, because different people have different tastes in how they like their stories told. I know a lot of people aren't fans of episodic series and prefer a story that compounds itself off the heels of each previous episode. It also doesn't help that it's quite blatant here that they struggle to flesh out each individual story well, and when it comes down to the various targets the girls are after, it just feels like a bunch of dialogue that goes on to lead up to the climactic battle at the end, while using spare time to dabble into the different symbolism used to give clues towards the overall plot. Although the special interest group Les Soldats, or the soldiers in America, are after them and that slowly unfolds as the series progresses, I found it to be quite underwhelming until maybe halfway into the story. However, I believe the true gold in Noir lies in its world building and energy exuded the moment you tune into any episode. The setting takes place in various towns around France, with Paris being the main hub the girls are based out of. Every episode is an experience regardless how the adventure plays out, because there's something to appreciate, rather it be in the visuals or within the incredible soundtrack that is highly underrated, or certain character interactions. I want you guys though to truly take in the art style here. This transcended simply being a work of art in which my eyes were looking at, and at some point became something my eyes could literally feel. The different places across France are so beautifully drawn and animated, and I believe this to be one of the last few anime in history to be animated 100% digitally free. Remember, this is 01. Some may look at Noir and figure it had a lower budget, which is possibly true because it definitely falls behind in production compared to its contemporaries. 2001 is a whole year into the digital revolution, and there's actually nothing digital about the way this show is produced. It actually raises my eyebrow and leads me to believe the show actually might have been held back a year or two from coming out, because it actually looks exactly like an anime from 98 or 9. Let me show you a few examples in 98 and 9 in 2000 and 2001. But anyway, that's it for this one. I just wanted to come in real quick and toss you guys a recommendation from something I've been watching recently. Studio B-Train went on to do two more anime you may be familiar with that were successors to Noir, Madlax and El Cazador de la Bruja, maintaining the theme of the young females with guns gimmick. But that's it for another episode. Like the video, comment down below what y'all want to see next. I'm out. Thanks for watching. Anime back when.